knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
In the previous tutorial, we covered the moss animals of Phylum Bryozoa, also known as Entoprocta. In this tutorial, we will be examining the goblet worms of Phylum Entoprocta. There are only about 150 species of goblet worms, nearly all of which are colonial, and all but two species are marine. They can be found from polar regions all the way to the tropics, though they are often restricted to coastal and brackish waters, where they colonize shells and algae. They, like the bryozoans, superficially resemble hydroid colonies, though the phyla are not related. Their apparent resemblance of hydrozoa is likely an example of convergent evolution, where two clades converge on a similar form that has arisen since common ancestry. It's kind of like how bats, birds, and bugs all fly, but they all developed flight after their evolutionary lineages diverged. Let's examine their colony structure, followed by their form and function, and finally reproduction. Like the bryozoans, the entoproctans have ciliated tentacles, but unlike the bryozoans, entoproctan tentacles are hollow and tend to roll inward. Most are microscopic, ranging in size from 0.1 to 7 millimeters. Mature adults are sessile, with long stalks that terminate in a goblet-like anterior region, hence the common name goblet worms. Their bodies may be attached to the substratum by a single stalk and attachment disc with adhesive glands such as in the solitary members of genus Loxosomella, or by two or more stalks in colonial forms like Ernotella, where individual zooids arise from either shared attachment plates or from a network of stolons, which are tubes that run across a surface. Interconnected members of colonial species are known as zooids, since they are not fully independent animals, meaning they cannot survive on their own. Stalks of all goblet worms are muscular and occasionally segmented. As such, most goblet worms are sessile as adults, but many solitary species, such as the members of genus Loxosoma, are mobile. Goblet worms lack a true fluid-filled coelom in which to house their internal organs. Instead, the few organs they do have are embedded within their connective tissue that lies between their stomach and the base of their ciliated crown-like lophophore. Like the bryozoans, the goblet worms feed and respire using their lophophores. In order to feed, their ciliated, mucus-covered tentacles are used to draw food down to the mouth at the end of the buccal funnel. From the mouth, food is moved to the stomach, where it is digested using microvilli. Solid wastes are ejected through the anus, which is located within the tentacle-rimmed crown, hence the phylum name Entoprocta, meaning inside anus. Respiration also takes place through simple diffusion along the lophophore and throughout the body wall. Many species also have a pair of protonephridia, which serve a similar function as kidneys in their excretory or urinary system. Their nervous system consists of a pair of ganglia that control nerves which run through the connective tissue and down the goblet, or calyx, to the tentacles and stalk. In terms of reproduction, colonial species can add new clonal zooids asexually through budding, either by adding new individuals to the stalks or from growth of the stolon. In this way, a single zooid of a colonial species can form a large colony. Many solitary species can also reproduce asexually, through budding, though once a clone's organs develop, it is released, unlike colonial species that remain attached as zooids. For sexual reproduction, most species are simultaneous hermaphrodites, meaning they are both male and female at the same time, but some switch from male to female as they mature, while individuals of other species remain the same sex all their lives. Individuals have one or two pairs of gonads, placed between the atrium and stomach, and opening into a single gonopore in the atrium. Most species release sperm into the water column and then capture sperm of other individuals of the same species in order to internally fertilize their eggs within their ovaries. Most species then release eggs that hatch into a ciliated, free-swimming trochophore larva, but others brood their eggs and nourish them until they swim freely. While an individual zooid is capable of releasing a large number of larvae, most do not survive to adulthood. However, larvae that are fortunate enough to settle onto suitable substratum will hold fast and metamorphose into an adult zooid. And that covers the goblet worms. Let's move forward and examine a third phylum of Lophophorata, the lamp shells of phylum Brachiopoda.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.